Hello students, in chapter executive today we will discuss about semi-presidential executive system in Sri Lanka. Today we will discuss about semi-presidential system in Sri Lanka in detail. Sri Lanka got independence in 1948. After independence, they framed their constitution, but just after 30 years, in 1978, the constitution of Sri Lanka was amended. They changed their constitution. They bring some amendment in the rules, and the system of executive presidency was introduced. They adopted the system of executive presidency, means the president was declared the supreme executive in the country, and power was increased of president in Sri Lanka. More power given to president in this country. Under this system, under the system of executive presidency, people directly elect the president. Now people can directly vote for the president. It may happen that both president and the prime minister belong to the same political party. ये हो सकता था कि अब श्रीलंका के अंदर कि प्रेसिडेंट और प्राइम मिनिस्टर दोनों सेम पार्टी से बिलोंग कर सकते थे और टू डिफरेंट पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज और दोनों अलग अलग पार्टी से हो सकते थे. प्रेसिडेंट बिलोंग टू अदर पार्टी वन पार्टी एंड प्राइम मिनिस्टर बिलोंग टू अनदर पार्टी. इट आल्सो पॉसिबल नाउ इन श्रीलंका. द प्रेसिडेंट हैज वास्ट पावर द अंडर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अंडर द न्यू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन द President of Sri Lanka has wide-ranging powers. First power, the president choose the prime minister from the party that has a majority in the parliament. When election take place for parliament, the party which gets the majority in the parliament, the leader of that party chosen or declare as the prime minister now in Sri Lanka. And the, who choose the prime minister? The president in Sri Lanka. Second power, the president has the power to remove the prime minister or minister. Now president can remove the prime minister or ministers from their post. Now this power is in the hand of president in Sri Lanka. Next topic, beta. Power is he or she means president. Now president is elected head of state because there is a direct election. People directly vote for president, so it is he is a elected person, and now he is the head of state also of Sri Lanka. He is the supreme commander in chief of armed forces. Now president is the commander in chief of all armed forces in Sri Lanka. He is the head of forces. He the president is also the head of the government. So now president head of the state as well as head of government also in Sri Lanka. The president of Sri Lanka elected for a term of 6 years. In India, the president elected for a term of 5 years, but there president elected for a term of 6 years. The removal procedure of president in Sri Lanka is very difficult. Now in Sri Lanka it was not easy to remove the president from his or her post. The procedure is very difficult. How? President can be removed by a resolution in parliament. To remove the president from his or her post, parliament will bring a resolution. That resolution is known as impeachment motion. That resolution must be passed by at least 2/3 of total numbers of members of parliament. Suppose there is a total strength of parliament is 100, then it's 2/3 is about, if you multiply by 2 by 3, then it will be about 66 points, almost at least 67 members must be in favor of resolution that president can remove. If 67 members out of 100 members are in favor of that resolution, then president will be removed from his or her post. If they are less than 67, then president will not remove. If the resolution passed by the passed not less than the one half of the total number of members, but जब उसके लिए रेजोल्यूशन पास करने वोटिंग हुई, सपोज हमने सपोज किया कि 100 मेंबर्स हैं, यदि उनमें से सिर्फ 55 मेंबर्स ही फेवर में रेजोल्यूशन के में, एंड वी नीड टू पास द रेजोल्यूशन, वी नीड द सपोर्ट ऑफ 67 मेंबर्स, बट वी गॉट ओनली सपोर्ट ऑफ 55 मेंबर्स, तो रेजोल्यूशन वाज नॉट पास. इफ दे आर लेस देन 50, इफ दे आर लेस देन 50, देन नथिंग विल हैपन. President will continue. If, but we take example that 55 members are in favor, the president cannot be removed from, because we require the 67 members support, because but they are more than 50%. So now, because it is not less than the one of the, because it is not less than the 50% of the total members of parliament, so now the duty is given to the speaker. Now speaker will decide. If speaker is satisfied that such allegations merit inquiry, जो जितने भी आरोप president पे लगाए जा रहे हैं उसको हटाने के लिए उसके पद से, if they all allegations are merit are valid to inquiry, then speaker will report. The speaker can send that matter to the Supreme Court, and the final duty now in the hand of Supreme Court. Supreme Court will decide that Supreme The president can be removed or not removed. Next. How position of the president and the prime minister in Sri Lanka different from the India? There are some similarity also in the president and prime minister in Sri Lanka and India, and they are different also. So the president in Sri Lanka is the head of state as well as the head of government, but in India the president is the head of state and prime minister is the head of government. So here head of government is also president in Sri Lanka, but in India head of government is prime minister. The tenure of president in Sri Lanka is 6 years, but for PM in India the 20 year is 5 years. In India we require special majority of both houses to remove a president. There are two houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. To bring the impeachment motion here we require special majority from both houses in parliament, but not in Sri Lanka. In Sri Lanka recently I told that if more than half members are in favor of resolution, then matter will be sent to Supreme Court. But role of Supreme Court is also limited in India with reference to the impeachment motion, but in Sri Lanka role of Supreme Court is highly active in case of impeachment motion. Now similarity in the President of Sri Lanka and Prime Minister of India. The President of Sri Lanka is the head of government, and India also the prime minister is the head of government. The president of Sri Lanka is elected person, the prime minister of India is also elected person. So now you have to go through the topic of semi-presidential system in Sri Lanka and read page number 4 and 5 from NCERT book of political science. That's all for today, students.